Might as well do the tutorial. Get comfy without arms and legs, fly and find your way to the simulation rooms. This is interesting.
Hello. Glad to see you up and flying. You are expected in the simulation area.
I thought I enabled some subtitles. There we go.
Find your way there. I have unlocked the smaller drone doors for you since only humans and controlled robots had access to the normal doors. Due to some technical issues, the drone door leading onto the simulation area didn't unlock. I have printed a drivable robot using one of our fancy nano printing stations, but due to a calibration error, the robot is upside down. No worries though, just move up to it and flip it. Good job. Now, if you dock to that robot, you can drive it through the normal doors.
There we go.
Let's take this robot for a spin, shall we? Look at you go. Woo-hoo.
Sweet.
Oopsie. Looks like the normal door is locked here. Confusing. Undock from your robot and go through the drone door to enter simulation room number 3. AI drone identified. Welcome. Commencing basic training program. Transferring data to simulation. Please stand by.
Nope. Didn't complete the last one. Let's go again.
Simulation ID DPT-01. Hello. Glad to see you up and flying. You are expected in the simulation area. Due to some technical issues, the drone door leading on. Good job. Now, let's take this robot for a look at you go.
Oh.
Oopsie. Looks like the normal door is locked here. AI drone identified.
There we
Welcome.
Go.
Commencing basic training program. Transferring data to simulation. Please stand by. Welcome. This is your very first simulation session. Your purpose in this world is to build robots to assist humans and make them thrive. A robot like that consists of three things. Parts, chassis, and programming. This particular simulation focuses on parts. We will have a lot of fun. So go ahead and enter assembly mode. In front of you, you should now see a simple robot that I have prepared for you. But one thing is missing. The part called docking station. Let's add it. All the parts available to you are stored in a catalog that you can add. To your left you see a list of categories. The docking station can be found under the drop-down menu called electronics, and then controllers. Open that up and select the part called docking station. Cool. Now place it somewhere on your bot. Great. Back out from part. Alright, since this robot has 4 drive motors placed already, all the programming has been done for you under the hood. So we don't have to worry about that right now. Let's print this bad boy. Awesome. I will let you drive around for a bit. When you feel ready, proceed to the parking area and I will go ahead and rate your performance.
Hmm. Yep, there's another dummy up there. Whoop.
I'm done.
Damn it.
Can't touch me.
Oh, you can hold it. Okay.
Welcome back. Eager to learn, are we? Great. Let's explore parts a bit more. Go ahead and enter the assembly mode again. As you can see, I have prepared a new robot for you. But this one is missing something else. Let's see if you can figure out how to finish this robot. I will give you a hint. It's in the catalog. Wow. Look at you. All smart. Good job. If you by any reason don't like the wheel that you placed, you can always delete it and select a new one from the catalog. Print this one and see if it works. Yahoo! Yes! Fantastic! Just as we did before. Drive around and have fun. When you feel like moving on, just drive up onto the content area again and we will move on to the next lesson.
I poke some dummies again.
Leave me alone. Be careful.
Oh shit. Uh-oh. That's probably bad. Oh, you can break the lamps too. Enough speed.
Can't touch me. Oh no.
Avoid all checkpoints.
I am extremely impressed with your performance this far. You spherical marvel. Your recent results were beyond my expectations. And that is not a statement I make lightly. For this last one, I will let you do it all from scratch. I will try not to disturb you while you are in your creative bubble. So, go ahead and assemble a new robot and then just print it.
So I gotta do it.
How are we doing? Take all the time you want. Make sure that you have added motors, wheels, and the docking station on it. It won't work without those parts.
Interesting.
When you want to drive that cool thing you are working on, just go ahead. Absolutely glorious. Now you are a master of parts. Makes me very happy. When you feel satisfied, you know where to go. I have some very, very exciting stuff for you in the next session. We will load you into another simulation and have a look at the chassis and learn all about it. It will be so much fun.
Show a dummy through the depths.
I'm badly hurt. Ouch.
This is a very hostile drone. Okay, they do give you a lot of tutorial, which is nice.
Welcome back. Now, it's time for us to get creative. The look of your robot will greatly depend on the design of the chassis. You can build and make changes to the chassis using a few simple tools that will be introduced in this section. Let's get started. A chassis consists of three components: plates, frames, and joints. A plate is defined by frames, and a frame is the bar between two joints. Using these three components, you can modify the chassis into the design you want. Let's start off by entering assembly mode. Try to print this robot and drive it through that doorway.
Ah. Too big.
That didn't really work, did it? Let's fix it. Hop back into assembly mode again. We need to edit the chassis to get through the door. Select the blue plate. You can move the selected plate by dragging it in the direction. Mistakes happen, and that's okay. You can always undo them. Try it. If undoing was a mistake, that's okay. You can always redo them. Moment of truth. Can't tell you how excited I am right now. Stellar performance. Head over to the parking space to continue.
Got some adventuring to do.
As I mentioned earlier, a chassis consists of plates, frames, and joints. By modifying frames and joints, you'll be able to make finer adjustments to your chassis. Go into assembly mode. Here is a very simple robot that I've prepared for you. I hope you recall how to move a plate. Moving frames and joints is done the same way. Easy. Try moving the yellow frame on the chassis and see what happens. Cool. Joints can be merged together. Just move one of them on top of the other. This is really easy to do. Exciting stuff, isn't it? Milk printer robot and head over to the parking area to continue.
Okay.
That's an interesting design choice. Looking forward to seeing what you'll come up with next.
Avoid all the dummies. It's this way. Sweet. I'm dreading that wiring section though. After playing Pyrotrauma.
Stuff around sure is fun, but to make art, proper art, you need to step up your game. What you need to learn is how to extrude. That way you can create new plates, frames and joints from existing such. We will try this new feature on plates to begin with. Enter assembly mode. Go ahead and try to extrude the blue plate, or another one, whichever one you like. Great, look at those shiny new plates that you have created. Using the extrude feature will allow you to build more complex and detailed chassis designs. Feel free to extrude a bit more, if you want to. When you feel done, print, park, proceed. And I have to admit, I see great potential in you, and that makes me very happy.
Don't worry, I'll disappoint soon enough.
Be careful.
Oh shit. Oh, there we go. Oof, get out. Really like the design of this little drone. With a heavy robot.
Alright, so art class is coming to an end, but I have one more thing to show you. The extrude feature is not only applicable on plates, but also on frames and joints. The method is the same, although the results you get will be different, depending on what kind of component you're extruding. For your final assignment, it's time for you to get your hands dirty. Figuratively speaking, think outside the box and make your very own design. I have taught you how to fish. Now, go, fish. Use the move and extrude features you've learned earlier, and build something cool. The graduation ceremony will take place by the parking space. So, when you feel ready, head over there to present your piece of art.
there we go. What is the splitting? No idea what I'm doing, but seems to be working.
Do you like inspirational quotes? My favorite one is, "The world is but a canvas to the imagination. It's so deep." Mistakes, only happy accidents.
Nice. Is that some random bullshit basically to meet the weight limit?
Don't let your dreams be dreams. Creativity is intelligence having fun.
I think that's ready. Hello, Living Dead Girl. Doing well.
You are a true artist. I don't know about you, but my right brain half needs a break. Thankfully, the next section is all about the left one.
I think I might have put the wheels a bit too high up. There we go. Yeah, thanks. God damn it. Hello, Mystic. Bad day. Oh, I see. I guess the off-road wheels are supposed to, like, provide traction or whatever. Will they spin a lot faster or something?
Ouch. I'm badly hurt.
Damn it, I'm stuck.
Oh no.
There we go.
I'm hurt.
I'll return with another one. Still gotta work out some stuff. The pictures that we took, the background is a bit too bright. So I gotta reshot the picks. Okay. Now we're on the wiring.
Welcome back. Now we will dive a bit deeper into what you can do with your robots. Let's look at some of the programming that you can do within your docking station. There are endless possibilities, but now, I will just guide you through the very basics. So, first off, as per usual, enter assembly mode, and then print the robot that I try to drive it. Doesn't work, does it? Nah. Let's go back to assembly mode and figure out why. Whenever you have a robot with a docking station on it, you can access its programming interface. The brain of your robot. Give me a minute and let me explain what you are looking at here. Here you can see your workspace and your list of nodes. The workspace is the grid where you place your programming nodes, and the list on the left contains categories of different kind of programming nodes that you can use. Right now, all the nodes that this robot needs to drive are already placed in your workspace, but all the logic is not hooked up. You can see the wire connecting one of the input nodes to the steering node, but it looks like the other input node is not wired to the power of the motor. This is why you could not move forward or backwards. But don't worry, this is really easy to fix. On the right side of this node, there is a small dot. This is a chip pin that is used to attach wires. On the left side of the power node, you have another chip pin. It's used for input to that node. This goes for any node in the programming. Input pins are on the left of a node, and output pins on the right. To wire nodes together, you just drag a wire from the output pin of a node to the input pin of another node.
I mean, this is basic level programming.
The input node will now send signals to your motor and give it power. Back out from programming and then print your bot to test it.
This is pretty much what I did when I designed a custom submarine in Paratroma. Find collectible.
Wow, looks like it's working. Cool. Drive to the parking spot again, and I will give you another example.
I'll eventually put that Paratroma submarine in the Steam Workshop. We're just gonna play a few missions on it, make sure that it actually works.
Alright, bring up your assembly mode again, print, and try out this new robot. Can you figure out what's wrong? Yeah, not the best at turning, is it? Well, I am very sure that you can fix that. Hop back to assembly mode and bring up the programming interface again, just like you did before. Have a look at the nodes here. Looks like we have inputs connected to the power of the motors, but no inputs for the steering. No wonder it was a bit difficult to drive. Since there are no more inputs placed in your working area, we will have to find them ourselves. Look at the list on the left. Open up the category called inputs. In there you should be able to find a node called input. Now we just have to connect the two nodes. Now, select that node. Its properties should show on the left. There are some properties that we can change here to make it do what you want. One input box for positive input, which would be steer right, and one for negative input, steering left in this case. Interact with the box plus, and follow the instructions. Bravo! Now do the same thing, but sweet. Looks stellar. Back out of programming and then print this bot and see how it drives now. Smooth. Work this piece to continue when you are ready.
I love this. tutorial bot. Kind of like ladders, but not as hateful. Hacker mode on.
Repetition time. Yay. Same deal as always. Enter assembly mode. You don't have to test drive this robot. I know it's not working. Bring up the programming interface darn it. The sloppy person working on this bot seemed to have completely ignored to program this thing. Lucky for us that you know how to do this now. Let's see if you can figure this out. You will need to find the power and steering node for the motor, and then two input nodes to map the keys you want to use to drive this thing. And don't forget to connect them with some wires. Good luck. When you feel ready, you just back out to assembly mode again and then print it, and go for a spin.
There we go.
Oh yes, programmer ace. Impressive.
Whoop.
You should know enough now to build your own robot from scratch. Build a chassis, place some parts, and hook up the programming. Head over to the parking space to continue.
Damn it. Will it float? Well, that's easy to test. It does not. I guess I need to find something specific. Seeing anything in the water. Oh, they ball, I think. There we go. Now we make one completely from scratch again.
Okay, just a few more things. On your journey onwards, you'll design many different creations for various purposes. These robots can easily be saved and loaded by using the Olive Institute bot interface. Let's try and save your current bot so you can use it anytime you want later. Start by entering assembly mode and open the catalog, and then go into the bot tab. On the right, you can see the currently loaded bot, and below that, the save options. Hit the save as button, and give the bot a name. A good job. Now I'll show you how to start a new bot, if you want to build something from scratch. It's simple, just press the Start New Bot button. As you can see here, there are a bunch of different bases to start off from. Just pick the one that best suits your needs. Then hit the Create button. Now build something cool. Remember, the parts you can use can be found in the catalog tab.
There we go. It's a spoiler. Oh, okay, it knows how to do this. Basics automatically.
Whoa, wait. Stop. I have more things to show you. Go back into assembly mode. Okay, before we move on, make sure you save this piece to the bot, so you can use it later. You remember how to do that, right?
Sure. Yep, there we go.
Okay, so here in the bot tab, you should now see the bots that you have saved earlier. To load any of them into your current simulation, simply select them and hit the load button. Easy. Good job. Well, I'm sure this was a walk in the park for you. Now make it a drive to the parking, and collect your well-deserved diploma. I am going into sleep mode now, but park it and I will unload the simulation for you and bring you back to the facility. I will make sure to find you when I think that you are ready for more. Hey, Doe.
Hey, Doe. What's that? Is that Swedish? Some customization things. Oh, hell yeah. There we go. press through all the checkpoints, park all the dummies, failed shipment, swimming ring.
Welcome to the Olive Simulated Challenge Course. Let's start gently. An Olive Institute building is at the bottom of this scenic hill. Create a robot that can drive down to the parking area. Keep an eye out for optional objectives. These will unlock additional simulation capabilities.
So off-road is, of course, good in off-road. Racing wheel is the best on asphalt. Medium will do. Medium. Well, let's try the epic car first. Oh yeah, this has racing wheels though. Seems to work well-ish. The car has a perfect tip for poking dummies. Speed. I wonder if there's a... I guess I could put a piston or something on it to auto flip. Headshot. Oh shit. Look at my little drone. Failed shipment. It's a bit front heavy. Static damage. Oh, there's a boat over there. Oh yeah, the star. I forgot that that's in there. Damn it. Keep flipping over. Ah. Shit. Reminds me of the stars in Going Quackers. Now you will have to climb to new heights, focus on power, crown clearance, and finally to make the jump to the platform.
The real world is a messy place, and humans use all kinds of vehicles to get around. The helipad is your goal, but there are many steps to reach it. For an extra challenge, simulate carrying some heavy luggage up there.
Finish with a heavy butt. Oh yeah, they've got, that's what I was thinking, they've got the drag system in it too, so you can make stuff aerodynamic. Medium materials strike a balance between weight and sturdiness. Light materials are the weakest but also the lightest. Heavy materials are the strongest but also the heaviest. Aero materials have vastly increased drag, this makes them excellent for airplane wings and control surfaces. Boat hull materials have very little drag, this makes them excellent for boat hulls. Oh, there we go. That looks good. Still not heavy enough for some reason. Oh, that's a heavy bot. Heavy but also fast. Oh. That looks like those shoulder pads Dragon Ball Z characters have. Dummies. Graceful like a swan. Yeah, just chilling.
I'm very fragile.
Going on a drive with a friend.
Be careful. This is fun.
Whoops. Fuck. I wonder. Nope. Wheels sound big enough for that. Spiked medium. Road medium. Wide off-road. Save this bad boy. Oh, bring it again. Drive through all the checkpoints to unlock parking, get you feel the flow. Complete the chain link, poke the dummies, collect star, parasol, and booster.
Time to head for the great outdoors, where robot can frolic and leap. Make sure you keep your grip while exploring and visiting all the ramblers. Go through every checkpoint to unlock the parking bay.
Yeah, Chunk should be able to handle this. Jump to get that part. I'd need a speedier car for that. Surprisingly, this car isn't much faster. Go for a new design. Just go with the square. Kits. Wow. I guess we should go with a smaller motor. Oh, and this shows where the center of mass is. Interesting. For ice, okay. Hmm? Oh, what did it? Delete the motor. We can do it. Nah. Man, that is a hell of a jump. More acceleration. Okay. Design change. Point tip, more aerodynamic. I think it broke the steering. Oh yeah. Can't go with the wedge. It looks fucking hideous, but it works. It's pretty aerodynamic now. Ah, booster, there we go. We've got some nitro now. It'll do. We just need to get to the jump alive somehow. That is the hardest part. Okay. About this. Got it. Nice, had a flip. Style points too. Fuck. Okay, then the dummies. Nice flip. These boosters are working well. My eye is drying from the fans. I could probably turn them off. It's pretty cool outside right now. Kilogram weight, okay. Is there anything else? Well, the parasol and booster, I think those were the other extras. So we can exit this level now. Control a bit if you boost. Okay, I got everything.
It's a tough world out there. You may need to use heavy materials to prevent damage to your core. Armor yourself against the slings and arrows and basketballs of outrageous fortune, and persevere.
Ow. Is the checkpoint.
I'm badly hurt. Why?
Jesus. Redesign. That was wide enough. Ow. Holy shit. Completely wrecked my car. Bigger wheels. Ow. Okay, we're making progress. Well, there goes the front. There we go.
Really?
There are also hidden parts somewhere. That's it.
Humans use these spaces for preventative maintenance and elaborate ritualized combat performances. Sadly, these devices are somewhat dangerous to mechanical entities. Do your best.
That's another good start.
Hmm.
Oof. Yeah, that's a reset. Shit. If you knock me up. Nope. Well, how survived that? Oh, nice. They're helping me poke the dummies. Some advanced engineering for this. Ah, goddammit, they knocked it down. That's when I installed my poking finger. Going.
I'm done.
Okay. LED bar. That dummy got mangled.
Offices, some chips contain ramps. Did you know that 83% of robots do not survive their first encounter with a basketball? Just thought you might want to know.
Holy shit. That is brutal. Ah, damn it, don't look it into a corner. Yes. Whoop. Well, it almost got to the goal. Oof. There we go. Oh, you're gonna drive through them all in one life. Okay.
I hurt.
Piece of shit. I got the hot dog. Okay. Gonna lure them into shooting at that dummy. Thanks. Got it. Well, this is a problem. Completely destroyed it. The one in the stands, yeah. Ooh.
Be careful.
Ow. Got it. Ooh, off-road lodge. Yeah, the boost is dangerous. Hold on, I'll just get the gold, then I can ban you. There we go.
Sometimes the best approach is just to charge recklessly ahead and see what happens.
Yeah.
Do you even need to stare? Really?
Exactly. Whoa. Well, maybe a little bit of steering. Oh nice, it still remembers everything from the last level.
Oh, no.
Oh, finish with a light bot this time. Okay. Oof. I wonder. What if I... too heavy. I was wondering if I could make a car like a roll cage that could flip over. Now, what does it keep mirroring? Ah, there we go. Oh shit. It's not programmed. Also, I think I put it the right way. The wrong way, there we go. Oh shit, this is bad. Oh no. Okay, got it. Jesus. Victory torch. Oh no, I'm so dead. Can't stop. Oh Jesus. They really don't show you any mercy here. Small piston. I mean, that could work to flip me over too. Oh Oh fuck. Just death all around me. Ow. Oh, there goes those wheels. Gotta just jump into the next level. Nope, gotta go to the parking spot. Not again. Oh, what was that? There was something there. Screwing me over. Let me out. So we have like a giant sandbox to explore or campaign missions. Put delivery boxes into the container.
Welcome to the dockside, the natural habitat of the forklift. You will often be called upon to help transport olive products to be shipped worldwide. This is fun and satisfying work for any AI.
Throw at least 16 boxes into the water. I just gotta put one into the container. Succeed. For big wheels here. Has the booster there. Let's see. F is a good key. Oh, I think I need pistons to move the forklift. Okay. Hinge, that's cool. Don't think that's supposed to happen. What happened? Yeah, let's try again.
Welcome to the dockside, the natural habitat of the forklift. You will often be called upon to help transport olive products to be shipped worldwide. This is fun and satisfying work for any AI.
Yeah, something went wrong with the piston, I guess. It keeps mirroring it, that's what it is. There we go. Okay, now we can attach the forklift. For steering and 3 is for power. Sweet.
Parking area enabled.
Be lacking. Fuck. I might have to make this a bit longer and give it some weight in the back. I think we can just poke the rest in there. There we go. all of those fragile boxes. Oh, flipped everything in there. Some footage from the UPS loading dock. Oh yeah, let's put some weight in the back. Lift the wheels just a bit to naturally pointing down. No, still don't quite cut it. Let's make it longer too. The rest is going to the sea. That's a tough one. Oh, there's a few up there. Okay, going good. There we go. Be another, all the way over there. All her. All her. Definitely Swedish. Fuel plate propeller. Let's save this beauty.
Welcome to the dockside, the natural habitat of the forklift. You will often be called upon to help transport olive products to be shipped worldwide. This is fun and satisfying work for any AI.
Cosmetics somewhere. Oh.
Run on time, but occasionally they do forget to transmit scheduled dates. Look both ways before crossing. Parking area enabled.
Hype train. Nice. Clean up first and get it with something smaller maybe. I think I have the power to lift that yet. I could use a hitch to like angle the forklift a bit. And I just hit it with the tip of my forklift. You can carry me to the star. There we go. Jet engine. Sweet.
Humans will use advanced technology, such as shells. This can be a problem for smaller robots, but pistons can extend the reach of any vertically challenged mechanism.
Yeah, really like GLaDOS type, but not quite as hostile. It's more sarcastic. Hello, Naomi. Don't go high enough. Got one.
Parking area enabled. Parking area enabled.
There are way to make it not like pull in automatically. Output A sends the current extension. How do I activate that? Thank you. fill automatically. Starts moving down. Idea. I'm sure you can do it, but a lot of experimenting. Okay, so it's gotta be about 15 over. Fuck. The shown number. Oops. Steal one of these. Postal worker is easy. Oh, okay. Could I use a different design for this? with much. Oh yeah, gonna swap to off-road wheels as well. Oh, I forgot to program it. There we go. How deep is the water here? No problem. Cockpit. Wait. Yep, well that's it. Undamaged goods. Don't hurt any dummies.
Not all packages are created equal. Some, for example, are very, very heavy. It can be hard to balance all these problems, but I know you can do it.
Quite lifted. Yeah, I don't have enough weight. I was struggling a bit. Mm. try this instead. This. Evidently not. His mirror again. Yes, it did. These are so heavy. Oh, we're back heavy. Gonna have the central point be heavier. Power of the thrust of the piston. There we are. It was the piston's power that I needed to change. It's a bit wavy, but oh no, shit. Okay, I don't really need the hinge if I just use the. Use the increased piston thrust. There we go. Surfing. Let's do it. Oh, I think it wants me to start from there. How the fuck? Ah. Oh shit. Let's just take a smaller car. Fancier forklift piece. A booster for that last bit. Let's see. What's this guy doing here? Creeping around.
Why? No rush.
Okay, you're coming with me, I guess. Are they like programmed that if I'm like holding them, they assume that I'm a rescue robot? That's kind of cool.
Thank you for saving me.
Yeah, normally they just say stuff like ouch and whatever.
That was close.
Guess that'll come into play later. Shouldn't have saved him.
It is holiday time, woo. But alas, some tourists had too much fun and have gotten into trouble. Carry them to the medical station. The gentle yet firm grip of suction cups may prove useful in this endeavor.
I think we can use the forklift design. Maybe a piston there as well. Programming as well.
This is weird. I'm badly hurt. Save me.
I think it needs to be activated. Sure.
This is fun.
Don't worry, you're gonna make it.
Parking area enabled.
Excellent. They can fetch the leg and their legs later. This guy doesn't have any skin on his stomach anymore, but, you know, skin is overrated. Your ass.
This is weird. Where are you carrying me? This is inappropriate.
Yes, it is.
Don't mess with me. Leave me and be careful.
I wonder if you could just suction cup the crate in the transportation mission. Oh, you know what? I could use the hitch right here. Yep, wrong direction though.
I'm over here.
Sure.
I'm over here.
Perfection. Future of humanity. I mean, they're still in pretty good shape.
No rush.
Oh. There you go. There's something in here. Emergency beacon, nice. Oh shit. Need more extension. Hello, brother. Yep. Broke my crabber. One left somewhere. Thank you. I really love my little bot. Where is it? Whoop, drifted a bit too hard. Oh, there it is. Yeah, I just want to make sure that I can actually see it in this mode. Yeah, I can. Let's go check out the customization stuff we've gotten. Oh, nice. A mask there. Well, anyways, I think I'll end the stream here. Getting a bit warm here. this is a good game. The other game that I played similar to this is Besiege, which is another very fun game. It's more medieval-like besieging. It's got a lot of weapons and stuff in it.